Hello everyone, magandang hapon sa inyong lahat. Okay, matagal akong hindi nakapag-record ng lecture or ng lesson na ito sa kadahilan ng ako ay nagkaroon ng karamdaman. At yung karamdaman ko kung ipapa-check up sa mga hospital, ito ay magiging COVID. Kasi lahat ng mga simptomas ng isang taong may COVID ay nasa akin. Subalit ako lang ay nag-self-medication, uminom ng mga vitamins at saka ng antibiotic. Tapos nagsuob lang ako kaya sa biyaya ng Panginoon ako ay kanyang pinagaling. Kaya ipagpatawad ninyo ang hindi ko paggawa ng mga lesson at dahil sa ako ay may karamdaman. Sa kasalukuyan, ako ay nagpapalakas lang. Mahigit isang buwan akong nagkaroon ng karamdaman at paunti-unti ay nakaka-recover na. Ganon. Kaya dapat ako ay marami ng lecture na nai-record. Kaya ngayon ay itutuloy natin ang aking pagtuturo na gagawin. Sa kasalukuyan, ang ating pag-aaralan ay tungkol sa isang authentic leader. Okay? Authentic leader ay nanggaling sa kanyang salita na authentic, totoo. At may mga factors na makakatulong para lubos nating maunawaan kung ano ang isang authentic leader. Ano ba ang isang authentic leader? Okay? Ang authentic leader ay mabilis o madaling i-define, no? Dahil sa kanyang salita na authentic. At sa actuality, it is a complex process that is difficult to characteristic. No? Merong mga katangiang napapaloob sa pag-define ng authentic leader. Okay? Yan. Isang uri ng viewpoints para lubos nating maintindihan ang authentic leadership ay yung tinatawag na intrapersonal. Intrapersonal perspective na kung saan ito ay nakatuon sa leader at saka doon sa ginagawa niya. Or what goes in on within the leader. Okay? So, sa mga leader, mga leadership scholars, merong isang katanggap-tanggap na kahulugan yung authentic leadership. No? Okay. Katulad ng sinabi ko, ito ay merong intrapersonal perspective kung saan ito ay nakafocus sa leader at sa kanyang katangian. It incorporates the leader's, no, self-knowledge, self-regulation, and self-concept. No? So, iyan yung pumapaloob sa isang authentic leader. Merong mga scholar sa leadership na dinescribe nila yung intrapersonal approach at sinasuggest nila na ang authentic leaders ay nagpapakita ng isang genuine leadership. Okay? At ito ay nagdadala sa kanya mula sa kanyang conviction at sa kanyang originality. Hindi pwede itong kopyahin, no? So this perspective emphasizes a leader's life experience and the meaning he or she attaches to those experiences as being critical to the development of the authentic leadership. So kung ang mga bagay na ito, self-knowledge, self-regulation at saka self-concept ay pinagsama-sama, doon ay madidevelop yung kanyang pagiging authentic leader. No? So, kasama sa palatandaan ng isang authentic leader ay yung tinatawag na interpersonal process. Ang perspective na ito outlines authentic leadership as relational, created by leaders and followers together. It results not from the leader's effort. So, kung gusto nating malaman at makilala ang isang authentic leader, dapat nagtataglay siya ng interpersonal character na kung saan ay kaya niyang makihalubilo sa kanyang mga nasasakupan. Okay, at finally, para i-define ang leadership na ito, ito raw ay isang developmental perspective. Developmental, meaning it develops in practicing the leadership. Authentic leadership discussed in the following lesson. So, authentic leadership develops in people over a lifetime and can be triggered by major life events such as a severe illness or a new career. No? So, taking developmental approach, conceptualize a pattern of leaders' behavior that develops from and is grounded in the leader's positive psychological qualities and strong ethics. No? Nagsasuggest ang authentic leadership na ito ay kinocompose ng components. Okay? Yan. Nagsasuggest ito ng leadership na binubuo ng self-awareness, internalized moral perspective and balanced processing. Okay, yan yung mga bagay na dapat maintindihan. At yung approaches to authentic leadership, formulation about authentic leadership can be differentiated into two areas. Number one is the practical approach. Okay, by Bill George. He provides meaning for authentic leadership, and the second one is the theoretical approach. Practical approach by George, Bill George, he said that the authentic leadership approach developed by this person ay nagpo-focus sa characteristic ng isang authentic leaders. Si George, nagdi-describe. Okay, dinidescribe niya that in a practical way, the essential qualities of authentic leadership and how individual can develop these qualities if they want to become authentic, no? Practical approach. No, based on his experience, nag-interview siya ng 125 successful leaders at natagpuan niya that authentic leaders have a genuine desire to serve others. They know themselves and they feel free to lead their core values. Especially, authentic leaders demonstrate 5 characteristics. They understand their purpose, trusting relationship with others. No, ulitin ko, okay? Natagpuan ni Bill George yung 5 katangian na ipinapakita ng isang authentic leader. Number 1, naiintindihan nila ang purpose nila sa buhay. Pangalawa, meron silang malakas na values about the right things to do. Pangatlo, they establish trusting relationship with others. Pangapat, they demonstrate discipline and act on their values. Number 5, they are passionate about their mission. So yan yung character ng authentic leader in an practical approach. Okay, in his view, George found that authentic leaders have a real sense of purpose. Okay, meron silang purpose. Okay, knowing their purpose, authentic leaders are inspired and intrinsically motivated about their goals. No, yung mga goals nila sa buhay, alam nila. They are passionate. Individual who have a deep seated interest in what they are doing and truly care about their works. No, a good example nito ay si Terry Fox, na isang cancer survivor. So sinubukan niyang takbuhin o tumakbo mula Canada. Okay, at patungo sa Pacific upang mag-raise ng awareness. Okay, bago niya natapos yung kanyang goal, siya ay namatay. Pero ipinapakita nito na yung purpose niya ay willing niyang gawin. Nakapag-raise siya ng awareness sa mga tao at nakapag-ipon siya. Kasi ginawa niyang fundraising yon. Nakakuha siya ng 400 million Canadian dollars na gagamitin sa cancer research. No? Why he was able to do that? Because of the practicality of authentic leader. Kailangan magpakita ng goal. Sumunod, yung tinatawag na values, okay, and behavior towards other based on these values. Si George ay nagsasuggest ng authentic leader ay totoo sa kanilang mga ginagawa. They have a clear ideas of who they are, okay, where they are going, and what the right things to do. When tested in difficult situation, authentic leaders do not compromise their values, but rather those situation to strengthen their values. No, one of these example is Mandela. Nelson Mandela. Si Mandela ay ikinulong at sinabi ng nagkulong sa kanya na siya ay palalayain kung i-denounce niya yung kanyang mga principles, mga beliefs and values. Pero hindi niya kinompromise. No, siya pa rin ay nag-stand sa kanyang mga pinapaniwalaan. Okay, Mandela knew who he was and his core. Okay? Alam ni Mandela kung sino siya. And that is practicality. So si George ulit ay nag-suggest ng isang bahagi under ng practicality approach ay yung tinatawag na relationship. Authentic leader have the capacity to open themselves up and establish a connection with others. They are willing to share their own story and others listen. And they also listen to other stories. Okay? Through mutual disclosure, leaders and followers develop a sense of trust and closeness. Yan. So, meron din itong self-discipline, another dimension of authentic leader under practical approach, and is the quality that helps leaders to reach their goals. Self-discipline gives leader focus and determination. When leaders establish objectives and standards of excellence, self-discipline help them to reach their goals and to keep everyone accountable. Okay, so meron na dyan self-discipline, no, under ng practical approach of authentic leadership. Okay, last is yung compassion and heart, no? Compassion at puso bilang importanteng aspeto ng authentic leadership. Yung compassion refers to being sensitive to the plight of others, opening oneself to others, and being willing to help them. No? Ina-argue ni George that as leader develop compassion, they learn to be authentic. Leaders can develop compassion by getting to know others, others' life, and doing community service project, being involved with other racial or ethnic group, or traveling to developing countries. Okay? Under ng theoretical approach, okay? What is the background of this approach? Nagkaroon ng leadership summit noong 2003 sa University of Nebraska, at sila ay nakapag-compose ng theoretical approach of authentic leadership. No, halimbawa, napagkaisa nila na gumawa ng isang issue of leadership quarterly ng summit. Gumawa din sila ng monograph in leadership and management at marami pang iba. Okay, nagsama-sama sila at nag-create sila ng theory on authentic leadership. Okay? So, bilang dagdag, yung mga researcher ay sinaliksik nila yung tinatawag na felt need and extend the work
at base. Okay? Regarding the meaning of authentic transformational leadership, there was a need to operationalize the meaning of authentic leadership and create a theoretical framework to explain it, no? To develop a theory of authentic leadership, researcher grew from the field of leadership. So, pumunta sila sa mga practitioner ng leadership. So, what are the components of authentic leadership? Number one, self-awareness. Ano yung self-awareness? Ang self-awareness ay tumutukoy sa mga personal insight ng leader. It is not an end in itself, but a process in which individual understand themselves, including their strength and weaknesses, and the impact that they have on others. Self-awareness include reflecting on your core values, identity, emotion, motives, and goals, and coming to grips with who you really are at the deepest level, no? It includes being aware of and trusting your feelings. When leaders know themselves and have a clear sense of who they are and what they stand for, they have a strong anchor for their decision and action. Okay? Next one, the internalized moral perspective. It refers to a self-regulatory process whereby individuals use their internal moral standard and values to guide their behavior rather than allow outside pressure to control them. It is self-regulatory process because people have over an internalized moral perspective as authentic because their action are consistent and their expressed belief and moral. Okay? The next one, balance processing is a self-regulatory behavior. A self-regulatory behavior, okay, process whereby individuals' ability to analyze information objectively and explore other people, okay, opinion, making a decision. It also means avoiding favoritism about certain issues and remaining unbiased. Balanced processing includes soliciting viewpoints from those who disagree with you and fully considering their position before taking your own action. Okay, leaders with balanced processing are seen authentic because they are open their own perspective, but are also objective in considering others' perspective. And last one is what we called relational transparency. Relational transparency refers to being open and honest in presenting one's true self to others. It is self-regulatory because individual can control their transparency with others. Relational transparency occurs when individuals share their core feelings, motives, and inclination with others in appropriate manner. Okay? Okay, so factors that influence authentic leadership, no? The confidence, and under confidence, there are different factors. There is optimism, there is hope, there is resilience under confidence. This confidence refers to having self-resilience or self-efficiency, the belief that one has the ability to be successfully accomplish a specific task. Leaders who have confidence are more likely to be motivated to succeed, to be persistent when obstacles arise, and to welcome a challenge. No? Authentic leader possess hope. No? Have goals they have known can be accomplished. They are hope that they can accomplish. They are also optimistic. No? Optimism refers to the cognitive process of viewing situation from a positive light and having favorable expectation about the future. So leaders with optimism are positive about their capabilities and the outcome they can achieve. They approach life with sense of abundance and adjust to adverse situation. It includes the ability to positively adapt to the hardship and suffering. During difficult times, resilient people are able to bounce back from challenging situation and feel strength and more successful as a result of them. Okay? The next one is the moral reasoning. Is another factor that they can influence authentic leadership. It is the capacity to make ethical decision about issues of right or wrong and good or bad. Developing the capacity for moral reasoning is a lifelong process. Okay, so mahabang proseso yan na dapat na mapag-aralan. Okay? How this authentic approach work? The practical approach provides prescription for how to be authentic and how to develop authentic leader. It is focuses on the 5 characteristics. So leaders should develop to become authentic leader. And what are those? Those is purposeful, value-centered, relational, self-discipline, and compassionate, being compassionate. The essence of authentic leadership is being a leader who strongly demonstrate the qualities of life. No? And how can we apply this authentic leader? So, because authentic leadership is still in the early phase of its development, there has been little research on strategies that people can use to develop or enhance authentic leadership behavior. While there are prescriptions fourth, in the practical approach, there is little evidence-based research on whether this prescription or how to strategize, actually increase authentic leadership behavior. Okay? Authentic leadership is shaped and reformed by critical life events and acts as triggers to growth and greater authenticity. Okay? Being sensitive these events and using them as a springboard to growth and to be relevant to many people who are interested in becoming leaders who are more authentic. Okay?
So that is the how the authentic leadership work. So ayan ay yan ang lesson natin ngayon. So thank you very much for listening. I hope I was able to provide you an idea of transformational leadership by being authentic leader. Okay? So, thank you very much. Bye-bye and God bless you.